Thank you very much. Good evening and welcome to everybody. My name is Mike Cohen. I'm a city councillor and responsible for the Côte Saint-Luc Cats Committee. And there's not too many committees like that on the island of Montreal. The reason why I am chairman of the Cat Committee is because of my wife, Alana, who, when I met her 18 years ago, told me that part of the deal, if I were to date her, was I had to like cats. And I didn't until I met Buddy and Tunsis. And following that, we had Bobby, and now we have the beautiful little Cleopatra. So, yes, I am a real cat lover. There's other people in the audience here, Dr. Kalen and her team, who've made me a cat lover. And you'll see Sam Goldblum shortly, who I converted into a cat lover. And there's more people on my list. But just more than 2 years ago, Shelley Schechter, the head of an organization called EduSha, came to Côte Saint-Luc City Council to ask for support in regard to the many homeless feral cats in our community. As I said, as a devoted cat owner myself, I sought a meeting with Shelley, and she proceeded to share the benefits with me about trap, neuter, and release. I discussed this further with Dr. Kalen and then Alana Devine from the SPCA. And when I heard about the staggering number of homeless cats in our community, I knew we had to do something. As Shelley will tell you later, it's estimated that over a period of 7 years, two unaltered cats can exponentially create over 400,000 offspring. Yes, this is a very serious problem. Well, we had an information meeting at City Hall exactly 2 years ago. It exceeded our expectations and over 100 people showed up. A committee was born that night, and soon after that, some financial support from Côte Saint-Luc City Council. The Côte Saint-Luc Cats Committee was established in partnership with Shelley Schechter's EduSha. By no means did all those people who attended our information meeting sign on. A small group of people, devoted people, agreed to become volunteers. And we are together doing trap, neuter, release, and this is the only proven humane and effective way to reduce the cat population. We've also been doing trap, neuter, and adopt, and we've been adopting, trying to get cats adopted, and my own family has gone out and captured little baby kittens and found homes for them, and it's a really warm feeling. The only problem is when you catch them, you want to bring them home and keep them. But I have a one cat limit in my house because my cat won't talk to me if I bring a partner in there, I think. I'm pretty sure about that. So we need volunteers, and we hope some of you tonight will consider volunteering for us. We're like, it's a wonderful thing when we meet and we get together. We have a lot of fun. We're like a little club. We share our little stories. We've all become very close friends. And so at intermission, there's going to be a table, an information table, and I really would encourage you to consider going to visit them and signing up. But tonight is a celebration of cats, and that's what we're here for. And the money raised will help in our program to trap, neuter, and release and get adopted more cats, and also to go out and do educational programming. You can find out more about us in the program book. You could log on to our website, our blog, our Facebook page. You could even call our hotline, 485-6800-CATS. And I'm very proud that very soon, Côte Saint-Luc will adopt one of the first ever cat licensing bylaws. And we're going to make sure that people who have outdoor cats, and that's their prerogative, that those cats are going to have a license and those cats are going to be sterilized and they're not going to be going out and bringing unwanted cats into our community. I would like to introduce some special guests with us here tonight. First of all, you'll hear from him shortly, representing District 1. He's a proud cat owner of Mr. Darcy, Mr. Sam Goldblum, Councillor Sam Goldblum. Also here, District 4 councillor, a very big supporter of mine, here with his son, Matthew, is Councillor Stephen Erdely. And where's Matthew? Wave to everybody, Matthew. Wave to the audience. There we go. Thank you. We have with us in the audience, I believe, the city's legal counsel has been very helpful, Sherry Bell. Is Sherry here? If not, she'll be here shortly. We have the Liberal member of the Quebec National Assembly for Darcy McGee, currently in the midst of his sixth election campaign in 18 years, the president of the government caucus, and of course, the de facto minister of Jewish affairs, Lawrence Bergman. Lawrence? The president of EduSha, you'll hear from her later. She is amazing, an amazing person, Shelley Schechter. Yeah. We are here at, this is the English Montreal School Board's former Wager High School, now called the Giovanni Palatucci Facility, Marymount Adult Education Center, John Grant High School. We have with us some school commissioners who I work with by day. She herself is a cat lover. She owns more than one. That's all I'll say, is Commissioner Ellie Israel. The school commissioner for Côte Saint-Luc, Sid Wise. Sid was once the principal of Wager High School. And the commissioner for Montreal West and part of Côte Saint-Luc, Joseph Lala. And I know for a fact Joseph and Susie are cat owners, cat lovers, cat rescuers. So we're going to try to get the cat committee going at the school board, Joseph. We'll see what we can do. Our wonderful event coordinators, we really have some super staff, and there's a lot of them here, but in particular, Harold Cammy and Regine Bannon. Also with us, our Director of Public Affairs, Daryl Levine. And one of my co-chairs for this evening, someone who stepped forward the moment I said I wanted to have an event like this, Fern Collier Pereira. Now, before we hear from Councillor Goldblum, we'd like to bring up to the stage, he's very busy because since Pauline Marois has nothing to do tonight, he's going to debate her at 9 o'clock on CTV. Let's bring up Lawrence Bergman.
Thank you very much. I'm pleased to bring greetings this evening. My capacity as the Liberal candidate here in Darcy-McGee. I firstly want to congratulate Mike Cohn for what a wonderful effort and bring us all together here tonight for such an important cause. And I promise not to be long, but I wanted to talk to you about Bill 51, which my government presented to the National Assembly and which was adopted in the spring session. The message from the bill will be very clear from here on in. Because of the new powers we have under the bill and the increase of fines, that our government cares about the welfare of dogs and cats. If I may, I will summarize the bill as rapidly as I can because I know you have a wonderful evening of entertainment here tonight. The first item on that bill is to be able to acquire permits from certain owners of dogs and cats. Two, to allow the government to be able to determine the maximum number of cats or dogs which can be held in the same place and by the same person. Thirdly, to allow the government to determine the competence and qualifications required of someone who is a permit holder and of his or her employees. Fourthly, to determine the norms relative to euthanasia of cats or dogs and to regulate this euthanasia. Fifthly, to establish the measures of prevention such as vaccination or sterilization. The bill also increases substantially the fines for those who break the rules with respect to these provisions in the bill. And the bill is much more extensive, but I've tried to go through this rapidly at this moment. But I want to tell you that the real people responsible for this bill having been drawn up are yourselves. Yourselves over these last couple of years who have been calling your MNAs, especially the Liberal MNAs in the west end of Montreal, here in Montreal and out on the West Island, to ask for provisions with respect to dogs and cats. So I'm so proud that this bill has now been adopted and provisions of this bill will be put into effect, which are so important on a humanitarian level, not only for ourselves, but for the animals that we love so much. So again, thank you very much. Have a great evening. And may we also go from strength to strength on this issue, which is so important to all of us. Thank you very much.
Well, I don't know about you, but if Jean Charest is reelected, and Lawrence, I hope when you go back to Jean Charest, you tell him that everyone in this room would like to see the new Liberal government introduce a minister of animal welfare. That is what I would like to see. Animals are very important. I haven't heard it brought up in the debates with Madame Marois, Mr. Charest, Mr. Legault, and at least Lawrence Bergman has brought it up tonight. So when you debate Pauline Marois later tonight, you make sure you bring it up, Lawrence. Thank you very much. I have one more PSA, and I'm asking people, please turn off your cell phones. As we say, emergency exits are on both sides where the signs are. And without further ado, I'm going to bring up Councillor Sam Goldblum.
Good evening, everyone. How do you feel tonight? I tell you, I feel happy. I feel very thrilled to look out at this sea of people and realize that there are so many cat lovers in this city. Really. Give yourselves a round of applause because it's very, very important. Mike was correct in one thing that he said, well, many things that he said, but one of the things he said about me was that he converted me to a devoted cat lover. And that's true. We've got a cat, unfortunately, he wasn't able to be here this evening. He sends his regrets. It's true. His name is Mr. Darcy, and he's the cutest cat that you've ever seen. As a matter of fact, all of you are invited to come to our house anytime and say hello to him. I'll tell you afterwards, offline. It's my distinct pleasure to introduce Alexandra Cohn, who has been performing in musical theater since she was 6 years old in community and school productions. She's acted in films, TV, and radio productions, such as Rumors on CBC TV and the movie Prom Wars. She's frequently invited to sing the national anthem at many events, including Côte Saint-Luc's Canada Day celebrations. Recently, her school's Glee Club competed at the Show Choir Canada National Champions in Toronto. Alexandra won the title of Top Female Triple Threat Performer. That's okay, you can applause for that. Her most recent film, Tale, continues to be screened at international film festivals. Alexandra will be performing two songs this evening. The first is A Change in Me from the Broadway musical Beauty and the Beast, followed by Secondhand White Baby Grand from the hit TV show Smash. She will be accompanied on piano by Maya Rand, and I'd like you to join me in giving both of them a rousing, warm welcome, please.
There's been a change in me, a kind of moving on. So what I used to be, I still depend upon. For now I realize that good can come from bad. Makes me glad, and I never thought I'd leave behind my childhood dreams, but I don't mind. I'm where and who I want to be. Change of heart, a change in me. For in my dark despair, I slowly fully understood my perfect world out there had disappeared for good. But in its place I feel a truer life begin, and it's so good and real. It must come from within, and I never thought I'd leave behind my childhood dreams, but I don't mind. I'm where and who I want to be. Change of heart, a change in me. No change of heart, a change in me. Second hand from a silent movie star. It was out of tune, but still I learned to play. And with each note we both would smile, forgetting who we are. And all the pain would simply fly away. And something second-hand and broken still can make a pretty sound, even if it doesn't have a place to live. All the words were left unspoken when my mama came around. But that second-hand white baby grand still had something beautiful to give. Through missing keys and broken strings, the music was our own, until the day we said our last goodbyes. The baby grand was sent away, a child alone, to pray somebody else would realize that something second-hand and broken still can make a pretty sound, even if it doesn't have a place to live. All the words are still unspoken now that mama's not around, but that second-hand white baby grand still had something beautiful to give. For many years the music had to roam, until we found a way to find a home. So now I wake up every day and see her standing there, just waiting for a partner to compose. And I wish my mother still could hear that sound beyond compare. I'll play her song till everybody knows that something second-hand and broken still can make a pretty sound. Don't we all deserve a family room to live? All the words came can't stay unspoken until everyone has found that second-hand white baby grand that still had something beautiful to give. I still have something beautiful to give.
Beautiful, beautiful songs, sung beautifully with passion and with feeling. I can tell you something, one day perhaps you'll all say, you saw her now, because she's got a great future ahead of her. Give her a real round of applause. I would also like to thank Maya Rand for her stellar performance on the piano. Give her a round of applause, please. You know, last winter, our CAT committee was meeting at City Hall, and all of a sudden, these beautiful sounds started coming from the council chamber. Some of our members walked out, only to see conductor Joseph Milo and the musicians of the World Symphony Orchestra rehearsing. Cognizant of the fact that the city has an agreement whereby the orchestra rehearses at City Hall for no cost, and in return performs one benefit, we asked Joseph and his wife Lucy Ravinsky whether they would consider doing so for our committee. The Musicians of the World Symphony was founded in 2006 by Joseph and Lucy when it was discovered that a great pool of professional musicians who recently immigrated to Montreal had no opportunity to make use of their valuable talent in their new home. The MWSO was created not only to provide these new Canadians with the opportunity to engage in their main passion, which is making beautiful music in an orchestral setting, but to give them back the professional dignity that they had enjoyed in their homelands, and most especially to share their wonderful talents with the music lovers of Montreal. That's right. The orchestra includes 55 musicians, about 80% from 15 different countries. To date, they have entertained audiences with more than 30 performances, as well as having produced several recordings and been selected as the subject of 4 documentary films. I know you will enjoy their performance tonight. I ask you to please take note of their website address in the program book. Now, the orchestra is being joined tonight by soprano Jennifer Pyra, who is quickly establishing herself as an artist to watch for. She first came to international attention in 2008 when she was awarded the Encouragement Award at the Metropolitan Opera's National Council Auditional Regional Finals in Washington, D.C. The following year, she graduated from the Franz Schubert Institute. Last May, she was recognized by the Conservatoire de Musique de Montréal, where she graduated with her Master's of Music. This coming fall, we'll see her heading to competitions in France and Spain. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to put your hands together and give a hearty welcome to the musicians of the World Symphony Orchestra.
Thank you. Is Lucy in the house somewhere?
Lucy's right there.
Thank you. We all need one like that. I'd like to welcome you all on behalf of the MWSO OSMM. We prepared for you a special program. We selected a good mix of the best, most popular songs of Broadway shows, as well as songs from popular film score. The best musicals, the best film, it's the best. In short, it's the cat's meow. So, bon concert. Enjoy the evening. Thank you.
a female deer, Ray, a drop of golden sun. Me, a name I call myself, for a long, long way to run. So, a needle pulling thread, la, a word to follow, so. Tea, a drink with jam and bread, that will bring us back to dawn.
Here.
true. One day I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me, where troubles melt like lemon drops away above the chimney tops. That's where you'll find me.
I was asked to make a little plug for the orchestra, but it's a plug for everyone's enjoyment. In the program, you'll find some inserts. They are coupons of the orchestra. And if you should want to come in the future and hear some other concerts of the different styles that you are presenting in the next season, etc., if you fill in the blanks there, the lines, and put it outside, I think there is a box on the table, will be collected and will be in touch with you so that you can enjoy the program. You'll be on the mailing list so that you will be able to tell what we are doing and when to your enjoyment. And I'm inviting now Jennifer to close the first part.
I could have danced all night, I could have danced all night, and still have begged for more. I could have spread my wings and done a thousand things I've never done before. I'll never know what made it so
Thank you.
Wasn't that great? Yeah. The good news is that they'll be back for a second set, but we will now take a 15-minute intermission. In the hallway, you'll find a concession stand and a table with important information. This is where you can find out more about our committee. Consider getting involved, or adopting a cat, or fostering a cat. We also have a donation box if you want to make a contribution. Thank you.
Well, it's a very exciting evening. The Côte Saint-Luc Cats Committee, first fundraiser at the Giovanni Palatucci Center. We're so thrilled to get the musicians of the World Symphony Orchestra to perform for us tonight. But more importantly, it's an opportunity to expose the need for more people to get involved in animal welfare, particularly cats. There's many, many, many feral cats in our community. We have a dedicated committee, and I think tonight, with a capacity crowd of over 350 people, we've sent a very strong message.
Okay, now, ladies and gentlemen, we have some door prizes that we're going to give out. One of the things I wanted to mention that Mayor Anthony Housefather was unable to attend, but last night he handed me a personal donation of $118 for tonight's event to go to our cause, so I thank the mayor for his support. We have some door prizes, and the first one is, I want to know who has a grandchild who likes rock and roll music? Who has one? Lucy doesn't count because she's an organizer. Okay. Okay, so Norm Zimmerman from Steve's Music Store, one of our sponsors. Norm, come on up here. Norm in the orange shirt. Norm, one of the executives of Steve's Music Store. Norm, right over there. I'm going to hand this. Norm has donated a Led Zeppelin. This is a Led Zeppelin book, right? A Led Zeppelin box set. Now, it might not be what some of us want to hear in the morning, but if you have a grandson, you may want to hear this. So let me see those hands again. All right, and the first hand I saw was that one over there, that lady, and Norm, hand her this beautiful Led Zeppelin box set. All right. Now, can I see who here tonight volunteered to become a new member of the CAT committee? Who here is, okay, come on up here. Norm, one more. This is a beautiful Steve's bag that you could use for your groceries at IGA. There you go. Now, Alex, I'd like you to help me with these things. Alex, can you please hold on to these things? Now, these are beautiful collector's Côte Saint-Luc mugs. And so who else here is going to be a new member of the Côte Saint-Luc Cats Committee? Alex, I'm going to give you the other one. Alex is going to recruit now. She's looking for hands. Start walking, Alex, and see who's going to be, because they're going to get a mug. The first three hands you see, they're going to get a mug. Very good. All right, now, if you don't become a member of the committee, we're coming back to your house and taking the mug back. We just want you to know that, all right? So, ladies and gentlemen, please, when the show's over, and I think we're all blown away by this show. I mean, this orchestra is something really special. When the show is over, we will be back and have our CAT committee booth for you to go talk. I'm going to hand the microphone over now. Make sure it's... This one, I don't know if it comes off, actually. Does it? I'm going to need your help. How does this come off? I need a professional. There we go. You need a 15-year-old to tell you how to do these things. Okay, I'm now going to call a very special person up. Shelley Schechter is the one that really goes out with our committee. She is the lead trapper. She crawls around under people's balconies. She is an amazing human being. And without her, we wouldn't have a Côte Saint-Luc Cats Committee, and there would not be an EduSha. And Shelley is right now going to make a very special presentation to some very special people. Shelley?
I'd like to thank you all very much for being here this evening. I think it's a fantastic success. We have a full house, we have lots of cat lovers, and I think the orchestra is just amazing, absolutely amazing. I'm overwhelmed by it, and I thank you very much. I don't only thank you from all of us, I thank you from Edusha, and I thank you from all the cats that are out on the street and have, at one point may have had homes, but right now are homeless. And that is really the idea behind this this concert. I am the president of Edusha, and I am the voice for these homeless cats that at one point in time did have a home but were discarded and thrown away by very irresponsible owners. Animal control has historically been picking up animals and killing them to try to bring the overpopulation of cats down. In the case of cats, in Europe, about 40 years ago, it was noticed that even by picking them up and killing them, that the amount of homeless cats was increasing instead of decreasing. So instead of continuing the process, they did a little research and found out that cats share a certain quality with other animals like raccoons, and they have an instinct called the vacuum effect. And what happens is the more cats that you kill, the more cats are created and the more cats come to take their space. So they realized that this wasn't working. So what they decided to do was they decided to sterilize the cats instead. Why would they sterilize the cats? Cats have a natural ability to, female cats, to reproduce 3 times every year. They can have between 1 and 8 kittens each time. So if you take an average of 4 kittens and you times it by the cats, you have approximately each female creating 12 kittens. By 5.5 to 6 months, these kittens are able to reproduce themselves, so that those kittens are reproducing. So the idea of 2 cats over a period of 7 years that are not altered can exponentially, from kittens to their kittens, over 400,000 offspring. Now, it sounds crazy. They don't all live, it's true. But the numbers are astronomical. If you have them and have them again, you're still looking at a lot of cats. Now, the province of Quebec has not been notorious for humane treatment of our animals. And we all know about puppy mills, but we don't all know about the thousands and thousands of cats that have been discarded by people because they no longer want them. And that they're very quick to declaw them, but not so quick to sterilize them. And so they go out into the streets, and they're looking for food, and they're looking for some protection, and they're looking for some warmth in the winters of Montreal. And they're looking just to try to get a little bit of food so that they can move on their day. But cats hide. They don't come out unless they can get something to eat, and then they run away. They're not interested in being with people. So they're more of a silent issue than dogs would be. So I'm here to speak for those cats, because those cats are truly the underdog. They are neglected and they are maligned by people for no other reason than they haven't got a shelter, they haven't got a home, and they haven't got a guardian. I started doing trap neuter release in Côte Saint-Luc. It's been 10 years. At that point, I realized that there were homeless cats that people were ignoring and having nothing to do with. I looked on the internet and found out about trap neuter release. It was the process of seeing that it wasn't working by killing all of these cats, and that Europe was handling it in a more humane manner, and certainly a more sensible manner, because it was diminishing the amount of cats that were out there. I went to the Côte Saint-Luc Animal Hospital. I spoke to Dr. Marlene Kalin and told her about trap-neuter release. She didn't know me from anyone. I had a cat named Katie, and I brought her in regularly, but she didn't know who I was. She asked me a few questions, and on the spot, she agreed that she would help me with trap-neuter release in the city of Côte Saint-Luc. Now, we went on for quite a period of time and tried to get more support from our municipalities and from our politicians. And in 2010, I received an email from Mike Cohn, who said, "You know, I have a cat. My cat, Cleopatra. I love my cat, Cleopatra. It tears my heart out to think that Cleopatra could be one of those cats that's outside with no food, no water, no shelter, no protection, and nobody's taking any care of her. Nobody's paying attention." He had an open forum, it was a full house, and it was then that the Côte Saint-Luc City Council said, "We have to do something." So, as I said, we formed a small volunteer group. Okay, we're made up of an oncologist, of social worker, of a CEGEP teacher, myself, I'm a business person, we have homemakers, we have retirees, people who can be counted on to help. We don't only trap, neuter, and release the cats. We hold on to the female cats for 5 days. So somebody, we had a couple that donated their garage. Donna Dulles didn't use his garage for an entire year because there were cages with cats in there and he couldn't bring his car in. All right? And he donated his garage. People have donated their time, their efforts. They've gone out trapping in the dead of winter. They've gone out to feed these cats with no thank you, just to know that they were doing the right thing. Now, there's been many things that we've done over the years, but I have to say that one of the most important parts of our cog is the animal hospital. Without the animal hospital, we're nothing. I can't do surgery. So we have to thank the Côte Saint-Luc Animal Hospital for their unwavering support for this program over the last 10 years. Now, I'd like to give you a small anecdote, if you'll give me a minute, which I think is very important. We brought in a cat not that long ago, a female. And she was to be, a female cat has to be opened incisionally. There has to be an incision. So when Dr. Zuckerman went inside and saw the female cat, she noticed that there was profuse bleeding inside, and she thought that the cat probably got hit by a car. So she called me up and said, doesn't look good for the cat, but we'll do what we can. So let me liken the inside of this cat to a garden hose, just for simplicity. So she went over to one part that was bleeding, and she mended that part. And as soon as she finished mending that part, another part started to sprout blood. And as soon as she mended that part, another part of that hose started to leak. This went on for 2 hours, okay? After 2 hours, she called Dr. Kalin, who was in her garden, doing her gardening, and said, "I need another set of hands here. This is for a homeless cat, okay? It's not yours or my cat, but this is a cat that has no home, nobody to pay their bills, but they treat their cats that come in, our cats, our ferals. Most vets won't even touch a feral cat. They're afraid of them. They're afraid they're going to bite. They realize there's not a lot of money in them. They treated that cat with the same respect as your cat or my cat. 4 hours they worked on that cat. 4 hours. And the cat lived. Now, one of our volunteers, Renee Karp, decided to name this cat Esperanza, Hope, okay? Esperanza stayed at the vet for a few days and then went off to Diane Libling's garage, and she took care of the cat for a good 3 weeks to 4 weeks. And then we didn't know what we were going to do with Esperanza, because Esperanza didn't have a home. And I have more than one cat in my house, so it wasn't coming to me. So we realized, and I said with a heavy heart, Esperanza has to go back out. We had no one to adopt her. She was a feral cat. She was wild. So I went and picked up Esperanza from Diane Libling's garage and put her on the seat next to me in the carrier. And then the call came in. Renee, I was talking to Barbara Dellis. I told her about Esperanza. She said, oh, that's not good. Maybe, I said. Hello, Barbara. How are you? Oh, I was wondering, how is Esperanza? I said, she's right next to me here in the car. Well, you know, I'd like to give it a try. Well, by the time she finished saying try, I was at her house. The cat went in, had the entire garage to herself. Donna Dellis is mumbling upstairs, another cat, and Renee and Shelly, and the cat comes in. And guess who has a home now? Esperanza. Are you Dellis? Barbara and Donna Dellis, could you show us who you are with Esperanza's proud parents? Without further ado, I would like very much to bring up Dr. Marlene Kalin, who never said no, never said die from day one. I'd like to bring up Dr. Melanie Cookerman for never giving up on any of our cats. I'd like to thank Margaret Nadler, who with great patience and tenacity screens our telephone calls with all those special people that call in. Come up, Margaret. I'd like to thank Beverly Beach for trying to keep a sense of humor and keeping the office laughing and keeping Margaret in line. And I'd like to thank Judy Walsh for wanting to take in every cat that comes in, but we all have to stop her from doing it. Unfortunately, we're missing Dr. Monica Cebulski, Dr. Alex Kent, Dina Sotirio, Cindy Weeks, Matthew Wimet, and Gail Gauthier. They're not able to be here tonight, but I have to say that each one of them deals with our cats in the most exceptional manner, with compassion, and we thank them from the bottoms of our heart.
Before we return to the music, an incredible human being, and I trust her to be my own doctor, even though she operates on animals, Dr. Kalin.
Thank you. I'm not very good at speeches, but I would like to thank you on behalf of all of us at the Côte Saint-Luc Hospital for Animals. As you know, the success of any TNR project is reliant on the unwavering dedication of all the volunteers that trap, feed, transport, and house these cats, personified by Shelley. As you have heard, we've been running a TNR program for the past 10 years, neutering over 300 animals a year, which translates into the prevention of at least 24,000 homeless births, and, as you've been explained, exponentially many, many more. Our staff is dedicated to the continuous success of the programs, from receptionists, technicians, to doctors. Margaret keeps the best of us, keeps the best of records, and Dr. Zuckerman makes the smallest of incisions. Thank you again for this honor. We still have a lot of work to do. Thank you.
It is now time to hear once again from the Musicians of the World Symphony Orchestra. Please note that for the Cats duet at the conclusion of the program, Jennifer Pyra will be joined by mezzo-soprano Anna Levitina. Anna started her musical studies, piano and violin, as a young child in her native Belarus. This continued when she moved to Israel. In Montreal, she is a soloist mezzo with various choirs and can be heard regularly at the Charizetic Congregation Choir. She directs the Kinor Choir and plays as a violinist with the Musicians of the World Symphony Orchestra. Ladies and gentlemen, Joseph Milo and his orchestra.
Thank you, thank you. Just a few words. This past 2 weeks, the world has lost an important composer for Broadway shows, TV shows, and film scores. He received a lot of awards, such as the Academy Awards, the Oscars, the Tony Awards, Grammy Awards. His name was Marvin Hamlisch. And the next piece, he also contributed to some of the James Bond film scores.
I believe this is the first we're doing, right? Yes.
So, as you have on the program, we're starting the second half with themes for 007, James Bond, and I would like to dedicate this particular medley to the memory of Marvin Hamlisch, should rest in peace.
Thank you.
poets. Another block. Pirates.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's talk cats. We're going to have a few pieces dedicated to cats, of course. And the first one will be the overture to the musical Cats, played solo piano by Maya Land, of course. That will follow Leroy Anderson's The Waltzing Cat, and then followed by the famous Memory from the musical Cats, sung by Jennifer. Thank you.
Thank you.
Isn't it fun, huh? Real cats.
Touch me, so easy to leave me.
Chaim to life. Thank you, thank you.
Sit down for a second. We need that microphone here. Can somebody help us? We need it here.
And now, we sit down. We're going to finish. I'm going to give you a story, short one, guaranteed. The composer Gioachino Rossini wrote all kinds of wonderful operas, at least 40. Some of them are very known, Tancredi, for instance, the Italian from Algiers, and of course the famous Barber of Seville. Now one morning, Mr. Rossini woke up in the morning in a special mood and decided to write the following duet. I'm wondering, what was he thinking? You're gonna figure it out yourselves. I'm inviting Jennifer and Anna for that duet.
We come back for the fiddler.
Meow, 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 meow,
shake your hand.
Wow, what a great ending to a great show. So ladies and gentlemen, we thank you all so very much for being with us tonight. We would also like to thank the musicians of the World Symphony Orchestra for their wonderful performance to help support our committee. Please spread the word about what wonderful animals cats are. They really do make the perfect pets. I'm a huge cat lover myself, and I honestly can't imagine my life without a cat in my house. Consider joining our committee, adopting or agreeing to be a foster family. Important information about our committee is in your program book, as well as information about EduSha. Feel free to make a donation to our committee on your way out. We hope you enjoyed the show. Thank you and good night.